we have our beautiful client mentee here. Okay, my friend Keisha, my girl. She's about to speak about her journey in the natural hair industry when it comes to having her own product line and brand, right? So, you know, she's here right here. Okay.
So how did you get to a place to continue moving fast and forward
your vision? Like, what inspired you to do that? What do you think it is?
Right. Well, it certainly wasn't discipline for me.
Yeah.
I'm still working on discipline right now. Yeah. What kept me going, what keeps me going was my passion for what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about natural hair and locks. I love that. Yeah. I can talk for hours, I can talk for days on it. I can talk to myself about it. And that's really what I'm doing. I'm talking to the camera, I'm talking to myself about hair. So your passion for what it is that you're talking about, your what you're selling or your showcasing, your passion for it is what's going to keep you going when you get 10 views, you get 30 views, you know what I mean? So you have to do it for the love and not do it for the results. The results are going to come.
Yeah.
You have to discuss that and know that. They're going to come. Yeah. But don't do it for that. Do it because you're expressing yourself the way that you want to. You're sharing with the world your love and your passion. That's what matters.
Yeah. Oh, so good. Okay.
So you would definitely say that one of the key things to being consistent is the passion, right?
Thank you.
Okay. Okay. And then, so not only are you a content creator, like myself, we definitely got into entrepreneurship and building our own brands and building our own businesses. Talk about your journey with starting your own brand, your own company, and transitioning to that and utilizing social media to also grow that, right?
Okay. So as a hair influencer, I got reached out to all the time by different brands.
Well, okay.
But eventually, as I learned more about hair care and just health in general, I didn't feel aligned with a lot of the brands that were sponsoring me. So I decided, you know what? If I don't feel comfortable recommending these products to people anymore, I need to make my own products and have them use this because it's something that I can trust. So I can confidently recommend it to people. I can be within my own integrity and recommend these ingredients to people. So I started making products for myself and my loved ones to make sure, you know, everything was good. And then I started selling them online. And how has my content shifted since then? I started to present myself in more of a position as an educator, as a teacher. As I was learning, I worked very closely with lacticians who've been in the industry for decades. I studied from herbalists and things just to make sure that I know what I'm talking about. And when I'm confident in what I'm speaking about, it shows through and then people have that trust in you and they will, you know, shop. and they'll come back.
Yeah.
So,
Okay, so also, what was that point when things really started to take off for you in the business realm? Because I know you know doing six figures or whatever in your thing, you put your brand type energy. So when did that actually start happening? Like, how long did that take?
Well, I started selling my products in 2018.
Yeah.
I hit my first six figures in 2020.
Yeah.
And I do have to, you know, credit a lot of that to 2020.
Yeah.
We all know what happened in 2020. People were home shopping a lot.
Yeah.
So that really helps.
Yeah.
You know, the fact that I have my own locks, like, and I take care of them, they look great, they're beautiful, if I can say so myself.
Yeah.
Like, being that, like, that embodiment, that example of what it is I'm preaching,
yeah,
it really does help to sell.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because you can see it,
the result.
Yeah. My locks were down to like here.
Yeah,
I cut them about a year ago.
Oh wow.
Of course that's not all due to my products and genetics as well, but my products absolutely helped my hair to stay in such good health. I dyed my hair so many times. It's not my natural color. I dyed my hair countless times. I've had blondes, I've had reds, so many different colors, and the fact that they were able to stay so healthy and not break off and stay strong is because of my maintenance. Mm-hmm. A lot of that is my products. Mm-hmm. And so people seeing that, they saw, oh wow, her locks were blonde and they're still that long, like how?
Yeah.
People see that, they you know what? Let me tap into what she's doing. Let me try out what the things she's talking about.
Right.
So that really helps my business flourish.
Yeah.
So basically being the embodiment of what it is that you're selling.
Exactly.
And carrying that energy and confidence in your products and the things that you're doing. A lot of the times when you're first starting out, people don't really, you don't really believe in yourself, you know? You start second guessing yourself, you start second guessing, like, does this work? Especially when you first started, like, you do a service and you are a beginner, right? So a lot of times you'd be like, oh my gosh. But I'm telling you, the more that you can be confident in what you're doing and you can create content from that place and you truly believe in the work that you're doing, sales come a lot easier from that way. You know what I mean? Let's see. Also, like, what do you think has been your challenges, like your biggest challenges that you've been through as an entrepreneur in this space, especially as a feminine entrepreneur? And how have you overcome this?
So one of my biggest challenges is that I never really saw myself as a businesswoman. I always saw myself as an artist, a creative. I'm a Pisces. I never really saw myself as that, like, type A personality, which is often masculine energy, which is really needed to really run a successful business.
I never said that
yesterday. That's a word. So I still do struggle with that.
Yeah.
And it's, as a solopreneur, it's a struggle, especially when you don't have that in you naturally. It can be really hard to, like, push myself to do certain things, to get certain things done.
Yeah.
So that's my biggest challenge, probably.
Organization and getting stuff done.
Yeah. When I want to lay down and listen to some Ari Lennox or something. You know, I don't want to work right now.
Yeah.
Yeah. And how do you also cope with, like, the ups and downs too? Because sometimes, you know, there's a little bit of a wave.
You know what? That's another one. I can be, like, really moody. Like, I've been working really hard to get my mindset on track, because that's gonna make or break you. What I've been telling myself, what I've been asking myself a lot lately, Keisha, what are you made of? What are you made of? What are you made of? And when I ask that, like, I'm talking to my subconscious, Keisha, what are you made of? And my subconscious kind of tells me you're made of more than what you're giving yourself credit for.
Yeah.
And that helps to keep me going when I don't ever want to quit, but I kind of do sometimes. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I kind of do want to just quit sometimes and just find me a billionaire and marry him already. But
it's still an option. You do both.
Have it all.
But I was first thinking maybe I would have been more intentional about like the quality of my content, but not really, because people want to hear your message. You don't have to worry about like having like the DSLR fancy cameras all the time. No, you can just shoot, as long as you have a nice window with some sunlight, some decent audio, that's really all that matters. So I wouldn't even emphasize that too much.
Basically, like, start with what you got.
Start with what you got. There it is.
Yeah.
A lot of times, you guys, people tend to wait until they have everything perfect and everything, like, you know, how they want it. Don't just go. You're going to learn on the way.
Yeah.
That's, trust me, I've learned on the way. I've had some videos I had to delete.
Who wants to have a brand and a business, even if you don't have your offer 100% right, you don't know exactly what you're going to sell, you know the stuff that you're interested in. You know the stuff that you like. You know things that turn you on. You know things that get you excited. You know things that you are inspired about, right? You know things that you just saw today that, wow, y'all, like, this really just made me feel really good, and just talking about an experience. The more that you can create content from an authentic place of really feeling good or feeling aligned or whatever the case is, most of the time, most of y'all are gonna be selling products or whatever services that you have something you're very passionate about. So just share with the world what you're passionate about and talk about it loudly and creatively and study what other people are doing and seeing like what works. That's what I definitely would have told myself. Just create the vibe, create the community, bring the community together. And that makes it a lot easier when, let's say, 2 years down the line, or right now, you want to sell products or services because you already built a tribe. And you have, usually, your tribe is going to be a reflection of you. Like, literally, a lot of stuff that I probably like, y'all probably like. You know, a lot of things that I want, or I want, y'all probably want. So when you are clear about what do you want, what are you interested in, what do you like, and you just talk about those things and share that with the world, it makes it a lot easier to have a brand that works, right? That really grows. Anything else you would say? Final words.
My final words are, you are limitless. Mm-hmm. That's one of my favorite affirmations that I tell myself all the time. You are limitless, or I am limitless. Mm-hmm. We do place ceilings on ourselves for no reason other than that's what we're used to doing. People tend to do. But once you start to, you know, break through ceilings, then you realize, wait a second, why was I holding myself back?
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah.
So you are limitless. That's what I got to say.
Does anybody have any questions for Keisha? A content creator, YouTuber, decade in the industry, her online, Sabria.
When it comes to selling products, basically the amount that you spend on inventory, that's the equation to it. So I also account for my time, so I'm paying myself my time as well. A lot of times people tend to undercharge for their products, and your business is not going to be sustainable that way. You compare your products to other products in the market, and oftentimes you don't know how much they paid for those materials, so you charging based on their prices is not beneficial. So I actually do have a course coming out in March where I really break down how to get your product-based business. Well, my course is specifically for natural hair products, but it breaks down how to make a profitable product-based business. So that's something, if industry, you can check me out.
It's gotta make sense. Does anybody else have any other questions?
So in moments you feel overwhelmed, what practices do you use in order to teach yourself and balance yourself?
Self-talk, EFT. Are you familiar with EFT?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Self-talk and EFT is what I prefer to do. Also, I like to nap and start over.
Yes.
Good one.
Journal.
Yeah. And you can do affirmations at the same time.
Yeah. Like what I'll do is I'll tap on mostly like I do this point right here, the karate chop point.
Yeah.
And I'll talk about the feelings I'm currently feeling and like I'll kind of like talk myself out of it. So right now I feel really insecure. I hate feeling insecure, but I love myself anyway. And I know that the work that I'm doing is beneficial, and I'll eventually get to my goal. I'm getting to my goal. I'm seeing my goal. Mm-hmm. And but by the end of the session, I feel relief. I feel better about whatever it is I'm stressing about.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Who else had a question?
Wanted to know, did you just always knew exactly what you wanted to base your content on, or did it kind of take you a while to find your niche?
Actually, when I was in high school, I used to make YouTube videos on nail art. I used to be really into nails.
Really?
Now my nails are so plain. Never have thought. But I just make content based on what I like. I was getting into nail art, so I made nail art content.
Yeah.
And once I decided to go natural, I saw that people were showing their journeys on YouTube. So I'm like, oh, let me do that too. Mm-hmm. I think it's kind of cool when people are talking about their experiences. I'm gonna do that too. So I just did it. Mm-hmm. That's it.
And so you just kind of fell into that being your bread and butter,
yeah.
Your main. Okay.
It wasn't very intentional at all, honestly.
Yeah.
Okay. It was kind of natural.
Whatever you like.
Right.
Whatever you can talk about.
Anyone else?
When it comes to like having products and like balancing like inventory and actually like producing and making the product, what is kind of your process of keeping all of that organized and like scheduled?
Well, you mean like organized, like maybe like
labeling and stuff?
Yeah, like, I'm not quite sure what you mean. Like,
I guess in the sense of like, because when you are doing like a product based business and you're wearing all the hats and doing it yourself, kind of balancing that, like, okay, keeping track of inventory as well as like when you're getting orders, like staying on top of orders. And,
I see.
Okay.
Okay, well, I must say that I do have a bookkeeper who's an accountant. Mm-hmm. And without her, okay. So while I do have 95% of the hats, I know I'm not a numbers girl at all, so I'm not gonna take on that big responsibility. So if that's something that you guys have an issue with, definitely get an accountant, get a bookkeeper. Mm-hmm. So I have that. As far as, there was something else you mentioned.
Keeping track of like orders.
Oh,
orders,
right. I have an app on my phone. I'm losing my phone, so I'm always conscious of, okay, I have orders that I have to fulfill. So I try to do it 3 times a week. So I will go like Mondays and Fridays, and I'll look and see what needs to be fulfilled and not do. So get new mini sales on Wednesday. I'm not going to wait until Thursday. No, do it on that Wednesday.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Get it done. Go to the post office.
Stay consistent.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Monday, Wednesday,
and
Friday.
Cool. To kind of follow that up, do you already have like product that is like made so that when you do get orders, it's like you already just kind of like pull from
absolutely
the products that, like,
that'll make your life so much easier if you like make them in bulk. So
mm-hmm.
when the orders do come in, you can just send them off. Versus what I used to do earlier on is I'll create the product when the orders came in.
But you get, she also gets to know like her flow. Like now she has an understanding of usually what her sales look like and what her days look like and everything. So she can kind of guess like how many products she needs, and she knows when she's gonna launch something and all kinds of things. So she can kind of prep ahead of time, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Beautiful.
Thank you so much.
Yes. Let's do one final question if there's one final question.
I actually have two, if that's okay. One is, as a fellow Piscean, who's also a Cancer rising and moon, so I'm all water baby.
Yeah.
How do you push forward? I know you mentioned a little bit that you have to kind of go with the flow, take naps, which of course I love as well. But how do you kind of get going, or how did you get going? What keeps you going? And then the second question is, can you give a piece of advice for someone that might be considering a box?
Ooh.
Okay. Okay. I definitely need coaches in my life.
Mm-hmm.
Having coaches and mentors absolutely helps to keep me going.
Yeah.
Without that, I do believe that I would be pretty stuck and stagnant. So
mm-hmm.
definitely reach out to who you think you feel aligned with, who can help you to hit your goals.
Mm-hmm.
As far as starting a vlog, I have a YouTube channel of 800 plus videos. So any possible question you may have about lock maintenance or natural hair maintenance, you can probably search in my name, Keisha Charmaine, and then that subject, and I'm sure at least a few videos will pop up on that. So, yeah, definitely.